We are studying soil today. You all see soil everywhere around you?
Yes!
Yeah? But today you are going to handle it.
Look, it is so big.
Ew! It's so dirty.
I have a box full of yucky things.
Are my soil scientists ready?
Yes!
Children are going to discover the texture, components, formation and location of sand, silt and clay. All of these by getting their hands dirty.
Sometimes get very predictable. So we want our students to observe, understand, and connect to what they already know. This involves critical thinking.
This is plant soil. Which plants grow?
So please tell me, what do plants require to grow in soil?
Sun. Actually, not sun, sunlight.
Oh, they also need air. Yes. Just like us, how we breathe.
And food. Do they need food?
Yes.
And what is plant food?
Manure.
Manure, yes. The plant food is manure.
I even made some grass and didn't grow up. Sand is also formed in the desert.
Through learning, we sensitize them about our environment.
Should we eat junk food every day?
No.
Right? But what could be the junk food for the soil? For the
chocolate.
Soil? Right. Anyone else? Mom. Yes?
Chips wrappers.
Plastic cups. Very nice.
Crackers.
My junior scientists, we were so amazing. You have done your task very well. Now it's time to
celebrate!
Think or soil, you may think dirty, but flowers are pretty and they grow in.
Oranges are yummy and they grow in
soil.
They grow in
soil.
A multi-sensory approach helps students to learn in a more complete manner. Combining senses is a benefit to students of all learning styles.
Why have you put the earthworm in the silt and not in the sand only?
Let's dig our hands in the soil and make a caterpillar.
Hello children.
Hello.
What are you all doing? I can see that you all have got your hands messy.
I like to make the caterpillar.
Caterpillar? And you made it out of what?
I like to design it.
You made it out of clay. Why did you make it out of clay? Not sand.
Yeah, because it would not stay.
No,
it would not be round shape.
It would not take a shape. Today's children have, you know, learned to be scientists. They've discovered, they've been curious. They have observed things. They have also been able to draw linkages and draw conclusions out of, you know, whatever they did. They've learned it hands on. And I think this is the kind of learning that our children need to be given. You know, we keep talking about children getting, being prepared for the 21st century and the skills of problem solving, of expressing themselves, of sharing and collaborating, of communicating. All these skills are the skills that children need to develop, and they need to be prepared for this in the real world. But if we leave it to the time when they pass out of school, then I think it is just too late. We need to capture it young, and this is what we've been trying to do in this experiential lesson on soil.